This effect here is made from circles that are stacked on top of each other. Each following circle is a bit bigger and rotates a bit more, so in the end you have a really cool visual effect. So to make that, we first need not to delete the default cube, and we also need a circle. So for that, let's add a circle, right? Make something like that. And then let's add bevel and subdivision, and let's also shade it smooth so we have something that looks pretty cool. Now let's go to the geometry node workspace and let's start creating our effect. Select this default cube here and add a new set of geometry nodes called swirl. In total we're gonna need 9 nodes, so we have already 2 in place, we only need 7 more to create this effect. So first disconnect these and everything disappears. We're gonna start creating an array because we need circles that are located on top of each other. Let's add a line. So we go to mesh primitives and add a line. A line has a number of points. So for example, this line here has 10 points. So it has the scale of 10. Turn it down to something like, let's say 3 points. Now we have one here, the second there, and the third here. And also in the spreadsheet, we can see the first one has the Z location of 0, the second one has 1, and the third one has the location of 2. So now on these points, we're gonna instance the same circle. So let's check if we have an instance node. We do have it. So you plug it here and select the circle object. And as you see, we have 3 of them. This is the original one here, and these are instances on the points. So if you add more of these points, we have more circles, and this is working just like an array. You can change the distance between them and so on. So let's add 3 points right now. Now let's deal with the scaling effect. So we need to make sure that the first one is small and the second one is a bit bigger and the third one is a lot bigger and so on. So we have to drive the scale of these objects with something that is different for each object. And if you check the spreadsheet, we see only the Z coordinates are different for each object. The X and Y are just 0 for every circle, so the Z is something we can use. But we have to get the Z out of this position attribute. So for that, let's use a separate XYZ, plug it here and type in here position. And we can separate it to X, Y, and also Z. And now we can access these numbers here from the Z attribute. And to use this attribute for scaling, let's use a point scale node. But the problem is that with the vector, the scaling is happening on all of these circles. So let's use an attribute instead. And let's plug here, or let's write here, the Z attribute. So now the first one has a scale of 0. The second one has the scale of 0.530. And the third one has the scale of 1 point something. Because every circle is higher on the z-axis, it's also gonna be bigger. It's a very nicely working thing, you know. So now we need to tackle the rotation stuff. So for that, let's add a point rotate node. And again, we have vector here and we can rotate all of those at once, but we don't wanna do that. We wanna use an attribute. Let's type the Z here, and wow, we have a problem here. Everything is looking very messy. And that's because the Z attribute is a bit too strong for this rotation stuff. So let's make it weaker. And to make something weaker, well, we can use an attribute math node and multiply the Z attribute that drives our rotation with a weaker number or a smaller number. So let's use a float, set it up like that. So it's gonna take the Z attribute and it's gonna multiply it with a number of 0, and it's gonna result back in the same attribute, so the attribute gets changed. Let's increase it. It's doing something. Let's put like 0.25 here, and this is the effect, and it's working pretty nicely. But as you see, we have 8 nodes in total, but we need the 9th of them. Let's take the same attribute math node and put it before the scaling. Let's change it to addition. Since we use the same attribute, the Z attribute, for the scaling and also for the rotation, if we change the attribute here so we make it a bit bigger, the rotation is also gonna change. So this creates this kind of a interesting effect here. So when the scale changes, the rotation also changes. If I move it, you know, something really crazy happens here. Of course, you can tweak it with this rotation stuff. For example, you can do something like that, and then you can add more of these, and it's gonna be a pretty, pretty interesting effect. I think you want to know how to add random materials or random colors for each one of these circles. So for that, you select the original one and add a new material. Then you add an object info and drag your random to the base color. Now everything has a black and white mask. If you want to use colors, I recommend to use a, let's say, a random color like that. Then you add a secondary color, which is going to be something close. And then you're going to add a neutral color, which is going to be either black or white. And this is a tried and true method that usually tends to work. So that's how you make something crazy with geometry nodes. I, by the way, finished this tutorial right on time. I'm going to catch a ferry right now. So I hope you learned something useful, and see you next time.